It's one of only a few prosumer-level domestic espresso machines capable of true line pressure pre-infusion. It operates with best-in-class steaming power. It features top-quality components engineered for superior reliability. It gives you the capability to take your espresso to the next level. Hey, espresso lovers, Mark here from Whole Latte Love. Join me now for an in-depth look and review of the Profitec Pro 700. Coming up, I'll have all the details on one of the most respected dual boiler plumbable espresso machines on the market. You'll see the machine in action. I'll have results of performance testing. I'll take you inside the machine and cover component and capability upgrades found in the latest edition of the Pro 700. Plus, a look at a water filtration setup to protect any plumbable machine that on the Pro 700 gives you the ability to control pre-infusion pressure. And if that's not enough, I'll look at a couple of machines with similar specs that are worthy of your consideration. A lot to cover here, so this video, yeah, it's gonna be a little on the long side, but you know, if you're going to invest in a machine like this, I want you to know as much as possible before you pull the trigger on a purchase. So, a little background on the Pro 700. It came out in 2014. Since release, it's been a top-selling machine, and over the last 5 years, it's really only gotten better. Now, I know a lot about this machine. I've been using it since its release. In fact, my daily driver in the studio here for the last 3 years is the Pro 700. The latest version has a few cosmetic upgrades and a few very notable upgrades under the hood. So, the basics, the Pro 700 is a dual boiler machine with PID temperature control of both boilers. The steam boiler is 2 liters and the brew boiler is 0.75 liters. It's plumbable or reservoir fed with a smooth and quiet rotary pump. The E61 group has Profitec's latest design with a single top nut and stainless steel mushroom valve. With components like the steam boiler, vacuum relief valve, routed to the drip tray, there's no internal moisture venting, it has an automatic shot timer, and a bunch of new capabilities via the PID control. More on those in a minute. It has massive low air sprung valves on the steam and hot water taps. Perhaps most impressive, a steam boiler which cranks out up to 2 bar of pressure for best in class steaming power. It's an innovation we worked closely with Profitec on to bring to market in some of their recent machines. We visited their production facility outside Milan, Italy, last July for a look at what's new. At our urging, Profitec and sister company ECM were first to market with domestic prosumer level machines running steam boilers at about that 2 bar of pressure. You can have that bump in steam performance not only in the Pro 700, but also in the ECM Synchronica and the Pro 600, Profitec's compact dual boiler, non-plumbable vibration pump machine. Now, that's true commercial level steaming power, and it blows away the typical 1.2 to say 1.3 bar you have on most prosumer level machines. Now, to get an idea of just what that means, here are some test results. On the Pro 700, it took about 20 seconds to steam 6 ounces of milk from 45 degrees to our preferred finish temperature of around 140 degrees. That means if you start brewing and steaming at the same time, you'll be done frothing before your shot is finished. And that 6 ounces of milk is plenty for a large latte or a couple of cappuccinos. Following 20 seconds of steam output, it was about 6 seconds for the boiler to fully recover. So the Pro 700, it's gonna be ready to steam and brew again before you can even wipe and purge your wand. Now, all that steam runs through a stock 2-hole tip, which provides a really nice vigorous roll. For a deeper look at steam power, I fully opened the steam valve and let it run for 60 seconds and had some stunning results. At 15 seconds, boiler pressure was at 1.7 bar. At 30 seconds, it was over 1.6 bar. At 45 seconds, it was just under 1.6 bar. And I finished at 60 seconds with boiler pressure at about 1.5 bar. Now, that's more pressure than most machines have before you start steaming. Really, very impressive. Also impressive was recovery. After running 60 seconds of steam wide open, it was just 16 seconds for the machine to return to about 2 bar of pressure, and 270 degrees in the boiler. If you are about the milk drinks, you're gonna have to go maybe say 3 times the price for a straight out commercial machine to get better frothing performance than on the Pro 700 or the ECM Synchronica, which has the same boiler and specifications. Now, if you happen to have an older Pro 700 or Synchronica, you can still get that increased steaming performance by installing a PID upgrade kit. It includes a new PID controller and pressure relief valve for the steam boiler. It's relatively easy to install, and you can use the link up here to our video, which shows you how. There's a link in the video description for the upgrade kit. If you're not sure your machine has that upgrade, you can check by setting your steam temp, that's T2 on the controller. If it goes to 270 degrees Fahrenheit, your machine already has the upgrade. A couple of other new features on the PID controller, a back flush reminder and an eco mode, which automatically turns off the boilers. To set these, press the plus and minus buttons simultaneously, then press the minus button quickly to cycle through and press the plus button to start changing the settings. The back flush reminder can be set in 10 brew cycle increments up to 200 cycles. The eco mode will turn off the boilers anywhere from 30 minutes to 10 hours after turn on, and that's settable in 30 minute increments. So I'm gonna get to the brewing and pre-infusion capabilities of this machine in a minute, but first a look at some upgrades and changes from the previous version of the Pro 700. A big one is a new design for the mushroom valve of the E61 group. It's now a single nut instead of 2, with the center top converging to a soft point, really very pretty. Beyond the cosmetics, the valve is made of stainless steel now, and inside some E61s, you'll find a chromed or ceramic mushroom valve. The chrome valves tended to be more susceptible to scaling and pitting as seen on this one. While the ceramics can be brittle, while not common, our repair center has serviced machines with cracked ceramic mushroom valves. Up front, new, more stylish knobs for steam and hot water controlling those easy to operate low wear sprung valves. Just a quarter turn from closed to fully open, and because the spring doesn't work, you don't have to crank on them. The badge plate has been reduced in size, and gauges are bigger at 2.5 inches wide and have more subtle black backgrounds, replacing what used to be white. The drip tray is large and pre-drilled with a hole to empty into the included collection cup underneath for routing to a permanent drain if you'd like to do that. Something I suggest doing if you're going to plumb this machine. If not using the drain, a screw with a gasket on it seals up that hole. Now, one place I always check to get an idea of casework quality of espresso machines are the interior corner seams of drip trays. Notice how the seams here are well finished with no visible marks. If a manufacturer does this level of finish in relatively hidden areas, it's gonna be a really good indication you'll find high level craftsmanship elsewhere. Now the Pro 700, you do. All exposed metal seams are fully wrapped and edge finishing and polishing is of impeccable quality. The drip tray rests on stainless slides to protect the frame from scratching. Underneath the drip tray are slots for the included back flush disc and storage of an extra steam tip. Proftec has gotten a little more into the branding, with P's now cut into the drip tray grate and cup riser. Behind the drip tray, 2 switches. The one on the left tells the machine if you are running from the reservoir or a plumbed connection, and the switch to the right, you can use that to turn off the steam boiler. The steam and hot water wands are insulated. For steaming, this is gonna help reduce internal condensation and produce a drier steam. For both wands, it helps keep the outside cooler, reducing the chance of accidental burns. Overall height is 16.5 inches, but can be reduced to 15.25 by taking off the removable cup rail if your overhead clearance is tight. Underneath the cup warming tray, there's a 3-liter removable water reservoir. But hey, this is a plumbable machine, so do yourself a favor and plumb it to take full advantage of its pre-infusion capabilities. And I've gotta say, if you've been using a reservoir-fed machine, once you go plumbed, you're never gonna wanna go back to filling a reservoir. Now, regardless if you're going plumbed or reservoir, it's important to feed your machine with quality filtered water. It improves espresso flavor and can significantly reduce or eliminate descaling maintenance. For a plumbed machine, our recommended solution is the BWT Best Max Premium Filter Package. That's going to include a pressure regulator and an optional flow meter, which will tell you when it's time to change the filter. Beyond standard particle and activated carbon filtration, the BWT Best Max Premium Filter uses patented ion exchange technology, which removes scale-causing calcium and replaces it with magnesium. This process maintains the mineral level required for best flavor while preventing scale buildup by reducing calcium. The adjustable pressure regulator is used to reduce household line pressure, which is typically in the 4 to 6 bar range, to the 2 bar pressure recommended by ProfTech. It also lets you take full advantage of the Pro 700's pre-infusion capabilities. So let's take a look at how that works. On most plumbed-in machines, there's a solenoid valve on the plumbed-in connection, which closes off line pressure to a machine unless the pump is running. On the Pro 700, the machine is always open to line pressure, even when the pump is not running. So lift the lever of the E61 group until just before the pump comes on, and line pressure pushes brew water all the way to the coffee without the pump running. Now, if you like, you can use the pressure regulator to adjust your pre-infusion pressure. You can set the pressure anywhere you'd like. It's a pretty slick setup and allows you to do those long, low pressure pre-infusions like you can on full commercial machines that can run 3 or more times the price of this one. So what's the deal with pre-infusion? Well, a few thoughts on that. First, it swells the coffee and helps to prevent channeling through the puck. After that, you know, it depends on the coffee used to some extent, but the general thought is pre-infusion helps pull out more flavor without over-extracting the coffee. So you're gonna get potentially richer, smoother, sweeter espresso without things going bitter. So let's go inside the machine for a look at the components. Now, I've used and been inside most domestic machines currently available in the US. What stands out for me about ProfTech and ECM machines in general is thoughtful, simple, reliable engineering. They are laid out well with electronic components, insulated from heat and moisture, with shielding and high quality insulation jackets on the boilers. They pay attention to where wiring is routed and related to heat sources. They do things like vent that vacuum relief valve to the machine's drip tray. In other machines without that, every time the machine boiler heats up, some moisture is released internally. They use quality components like a one-piece chassis front to back and solid accessible boiler mounts. Hydraulics are routed well with no crazy bends, and there are tiny things you'll likely never notice but can make a big difference in future serviceability. Now, for a grinder which pairs well with this machine, have a look at the ProfTech Pro T64. It's a 64 millimeter flat burr grinder, nearly identical overall height to the 700, complementary styling, and a powerful 450 watt motor. Worm gear adjustment allows for super precise control of grind size. That worm gear, it's an increasingly popular setup, and we're starting to see it on more grinders from other manufacturers. The T64 has 2-time grinding presets and a dosing funnel which accurately distributes fluffy grinds to your portafilter. If you want to soup up the T64, optional titanium-coated burrs are not only strikingly beautiful, it's too bad you can't look at them while they're doing their thing, but they have a slightly steeper cutting angle for faster and more precise grinding and have 3 times the lifespan of the stock burrs. They're rated for better than 2,600 pounds of grinding. I did some quick math, and that's a pound a week for 50 years before replacement. And the nice thing with that, feed the Pro 700 with some good water, do proper maintenance, and it could be making coffee along with your grinder in 50 years as well. Now, if you're interested in the Pro 700, a couple of other machines to look at in ProfTech's Pro 600 and their sister companies ECM's Synchronica. The 600, it's a compact dual boiler reservoir only machine with vibration pump. It has the same 2 bar of steaming pressure as the 700, but makes it in a smaller 1 liter steam boiler. The Synchronica has identical internal components and specs as the Pro 700. It takes things a step further with lever operated valves, angled portafilters, tapered E61 group, a unique solid black anthracite base, and additional styling touches. If interested in either of those machines, check the video description for links to videos on both. That's the Profitec Pro 700. If you have any questions on this machine or anything coffee, use those comments and I'll get you a detailed answer, or you can talk to one of our coffee pros by phone, chat, or email. Contact info for that, that's down in the video description. I'm Mark, thanks for watching, and I hope you'll come on back soon for more of the best on everything coffee, brought to you by Whole Latte Love. Want to learn more? Subscribe now so you'll know about the latest videos on everything coffee from Whole Latte Love.